met on a camp with Rob McKenzie and Tim from Tank Tracks Bushcraft. We're going to be joined later by Steve, Sparky Steve, and Phil from Outdoor Lip One. Never been here before. It's near Winchester. Deciduous woodland. As you can see, it's all barren. It's positively Baltic. We had snow on the way down. Gloves, wearing gloves now, and insulating layers. So it'll be an interesting weekend away. Hope I stay warm. Got the tents. I'm in a tent in my Lux Hex Peak. Tim's bought a Lux Hex Peak as well, and he's pitching that. And Rob is in a hammock. The others haven't joined us yet, so not sure what they're going to be using. It's got cold. The sun's shining, setting now though, and Rob McKenzie has morphed into Scott of the Arctic. Steve, Sparky Steve's here.
Oh yeah.
And we've got the main sort of centrepiece, if you like. We do have some cooking and heating on that, and Steve's set up in a carp fishing bed. With very, very heavy canvas tarp over the top.
It's a real nice soft
light, you know.
Yeah.
There's a couple just come in there, aren't they? I think I see them coming down, that they were coming in.
Bring it.
Breakfast hash.
I've made my morning.
Oh. Breakfast hash.
Wake and bake.
Hash for breakfast.
That's exactly what I want.
Get a hash for breakfast.
In here I've got all my wood stove cooking kit. So I've got the 12 centimeter billy can, the GSI kettle, a lovely black iron frying pan with a fold out handle, a canteen and a saw and a knife for procuring the wood, and a couple of wooden spoons for stirring the food with.
Ha ha ha!
Well, we was joined last night by Phil. This is Outdoor Lit 1 is his YouTube channel. And he's got this fantastic...
Outdoor Lit now, is it?
Outdoor Lit. He's got this... what's it called, Phil?
Swag bag.
A swag bag?
Yeah.
It's really sort of heavy duck canvas. It's not a backpacking light thing, is it?
Definitely not. It's bigger than my backpack.
Yeah. But really comfortable. And no condensation, you say, or very little?
Only on the netting. The canvas is dry as a bone.
Oh, goodness me, that's fantastic.
Yeah, nice and warm. I did have cold legs at one point, but I just wrapped my softy jacket around my legs and that was fine.
Yeah, lovely job. And didn't you have a sleeping bag then?
Yeah. I've got another one that I roll up as a pillow that I can use.
Fair enough.
I had to pinch Phil's spare sleeping bag here because I managed to break the zip on my bloody...
How warm was you last night, Steve?
My feet got cold. The zip failed last night when I went to zip it up. Luckily enough, it's got a bit like a... I nicked my shoelace out and used the eyelets just to like hold it together and then... Had these over the top of me, but my feet did get cold.
And you survived the night, that's the main thing.
I was alright, but I don't want to get out yet because I'm just so cozy in here.
Birch Australian Wills Country Outfitters.
See some of the kit they have though.
Oh, yeah,
really
like,
some of the.
We're out on a walk. Tim. Tank tracks behind me is on a keep fit. He's trying to do 10 to 16,000 steps a day. Rob McKenzie severely twisted his ankle a few months back, and I think he's got a bit of rheumatism in that ankle now, but he's being brave and walking on. So we're going for
a dodgy hip.
Phil's got a dodgy hip.
Steve's
got a
broke my hip just over a year ago.
He broke his hip. I got a dodgy head. so
I'd like to say Phil was the only normal one, but he's not.
No one's normal here. No one's normal here. So we found this lovely footpath, and we're going for a walk along here. And look at that! Isn't that a beautiful sight? It is a beautiful sight, Phil, isn't it?
Sorry, Danny.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Oh, it's beautiful. It's stunning. It doesn't look like it's one that's used much, to be honest.
No.
I mean, we've been coming to using this woodland here for. Probably close to 4 years now, and we've never made the effort to come. We've gone along the bridleway that we were just on, and then Sandy sees an arrow going this way, and he said, "Should we take a chance?"
But we lost him, didn't we?
Well, I wasn't the one with the map.
walking with locals.
Yeah. So Timmy is on a challenge to get himself fit. I mean, you've lost a lot of weight, Tim, haven't you?
6 stone now.
You've lost 6 stone in how long?
6 months.
That's incredible.
Yeah, so
and then next year we're walking the Ridgeway.
We are, April.
Yeah, and Rob, you're coming with us, Rob, aren't you?
We'll see what happens.
I'll leave you with that sound for a little while. Well, I wake to a very damp scene. I think it's rained most of the night. It's still raining quite heavy now. My tent got some water down here. We've had a leak. Some water's got in. I don't think you can see it. But I think it's coming in from up here somewhere. Not a lot of water, but it let some water in. And I haven't seam sealed this.
when you get these luxes, you're supposed to seam seal them. Well, I haven't seam sealed it, so it has leaked a little bit, but it hasn't gone into the sleeping compartment down here. That's still dry. That's what it's like out there. A damp day. A lot warmer than yesterday, though. Let's get the morning brew on. I'm packing up now, but the water out there, you see that there, it's run underneath my ground sheet, but not a drop's got in, so that's testament to the integrity of the ground sheet of Deluxe Peak anyway. Well, there's Tim, almost packed up now. You had a dry night, Tim, didn't you?
Yeah.
You didn't leak at all, your tent?
Well, I'm not sure. Packing it away, it was rather damp.
Yeah.
On the underside, but
yeah, well done, mate.
I haven't sealed it yet.
Listen, and Phil's all packed up now.
I'm all done.
You had a good night, didn't you, Tim? In yours.
Yeah, slept really well. Yeah.
Well done, mate.
Till the rain woke me up.
I'm sure we'll have another camp together at some point.
I'm sure we will, Sandy.
And Rob over here. The moon was shining at about 7:30. Rob's yet to pack up, but he's almost there. Well, is he? Is he almost there? He's starting to get there, he says. Anyway, there is a definite drop in temperature again now, and big snow is forecast for a lot of the UK today. So I'll make this one the final. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.